Here is the summary of the story Glimpses of India, A Baker from Goa by Lucio Rodrigues. Elders of Goan community fondly remember the Portuguese rulers of Goa and their appetite for bread. The author remarks that even though the Portuguese are gone, the ones who knead, shape and bake the bread, that is the bakers, are still alive. Despite changing times, the baker or peda remained an essential figure in the Goan community. The author remembers with fondness the jingling thud of bamboo stick announcing the baker's arrival. He would pass by their house at least twice a day. He would balance the bread basket on his head with one hand while banging the bamboo stick with the other hand. As children, they used to rush out of the house and greet the baker. What they were looking for were bread bangles, a traditional Goan bread shaped like rings which the baker sold along with loaves for the adults. The baker would greet the lady of the house. The children would then be pushed aside so that the baker could hand over the loaves to the servant. Undaunted, the children would climb up a bench to take a peep into the basket. They would not wait to brush their teeth to eat the bread. After all, there was hot tea with bread to clean up everything nicely. From a personal anecdote, the author moves on to the peda's integral role in the Goan community. Marriage gifts in the Goan community were incomplete without the traditional sweet bread known as bol. For engagements, mothers were expected to prepare sandwiches for their guests. For Christmas or other festivals, cakes and bolinhas, that is traditional coconut cookies, were essential. In the old days, bakers wore a special long frock which reached their knees. This dress was known as the kabai. The author remembers the trademark knee-length trousers worn by the baker of his childhood. Even now, if anyone wore trousers reaching to his knees, he invited the comment of being dressed like a peda. Bakers, in their glory days, also used to make a lot of money. Their plump bodies were proof of their profitable profession. The author humorously remarks that even now, anyone with a healthy appearance was still compared to a baker.